So straight on with the women, and we've got Sarah Balza from France, world number one. And never won a Grand Prix, Balza. PB in Grand Prix, a silver in Seoul at the end of last season. And her opponent, Manon Apeti Brunei, won a silver here in 2022. European champion, bronze medalist in Tokyo at the Olympic Games, Apeti Brunei. And Apeti Brunei, after the Tokyo Olympic Games, opted to go for shoulder surgery. It was a niggling injury that she had that needed to be sorted out. She went and had that operation, and it's taken her a while to get back into the very top flight. And while she was away, Sarah Balza really improved her form and her world ranking. Balza trains with the French national team, and Manon Apeti Brunei is part of the Christian Bauer private training group, international group. Bruno Apeti trains with her husband, Bolard Apeti. They will, of course, be part of the super strong French team that will compete in Paris 2024. Won silver as a team at the last Olympic Games in Tokyo 2021, it was in the end. Well, the crowd really don't know who to support here, because they are going to be cheering for both of them when it comes to the Olympics. Balza that's got the early lead. Points on the board for Apeti Brunei. So they came in together, but Balza were able to pick up the right of way with the Remise. Balza not ready, no card given. My referee opting to say that that one was simultaneous, so nothing given. And Apeti Brunei with a little bit of thinking to do. Balza has really improved her, the physical nature of her game. Bruno staying in touch. Ooh. We're going to see a card here. And a card for Bowser for not starting. Appetit Bruno just seizing the moment there. So the referee going and having a look at the video of her own volition on this, and both of the fencers looking up at the big screen. And we are level pegging, six apiece. Well, this one is always going to be too close to call. Very well constructed attack there from Manon Appetit Bruno. Good footwork coming forward. Patient pushing Bowser back to the end of the piece and finding the right moment to launch the attack. Now, it's going to be another card for Bowser. The referee saying it was her fault, and they'll go back on guard. Appetit Bruno's attack falls short. Bowser picks up the right of way. So we're waiting for the video now. We go seven apiece. Next point will take us to the break. Who will lead? And it is Manon Appetit Bruno. I think that might be the first time that she has led in the match. And we go to the break. 1 minute break, no coaching. Even though they're coached by completely different setups, they are two fencers of the same nation that are against each other. So no one to chat to. And they really want to get on with this. Appetit Bruno deep in thought. Time for the second period. Appetit Bruno just made her mind up there as she came off the line. Again, Appetit Bruno picking up the right of way, quicker off the line. And able to finish, and now it's a 3-point lead. Appetit Bruno after the break has really hit the turbo button on this one. Bowser gets one back, stays in touch. Well, they're going to have a look at the video on this one. Yeah, so the last reprise came from Apathy Brunei. Takes the score to 12-8. Not there yet. And again, Sarah Bowser asking for a video review. Preparation called. So the referee just explaining there to Bowser that she let the hand go down and back, and that effectively switched the right of way over. A big call. Man on Apathy Brunei, just two away. Wow. Parry, counter parry, Ramiz. Well, it was messy, but it gets Manon Apathy Brunei to within one. Well, referee's having a look at this. Apathy Brunei hesitated and then whipped her mask off, celebrated. But was the celebration too early? No, it wasn't. Apathy Brunei's done it. 15-8. Now on Apathy Brunei defeats her teammate, Sarah Bowser. A big win for Apathy Brunei. Sarah Bowser has got herself up to number one ranked fencer in the world. And Apathy Brunei coming back after that shoulder surgery after the Olympic Games in Tokyo. Apathy Brunei is right back in it. And she will go and fence for the gold medal here. But who will be her opponent? The second of the women's semi-finals coming up in just a moment's time. Let's have a look at some of the replays from this enthralling first women's semi.